Hey people, it is Tuesday, August the 30th. The time is 11:27 in the morning. It's currently 22 degrees and raining fairly heavily at times. And I'm here at the corner of Bay Street and King Street West. And I thought I'd do something a little different and maybe fun today. I thought I'd take a walk starting here, the center of the financial district. And every time I come to a intersection, I will take a right turn. And then when I come to the next intersection, I'll take a left turn. And then I'll just do that again, right, left at every intersection I come to. And let's see where I end up after, say, 30 minutes. I'm not sure where that will get me. I know I'll be going in a northeasterly direction, but after 30 minutes of rights and lefts at every intersection, I'll be curious to see where I end up. So let's take a right here at King and Bay. Both of my socks are already soaked. So this will be quite the squishy walk. So I'm thinking after 30 minutes of this, I'll end up somewhere in the St. Jamestown area, perhaps. Of course, when I was planning to do this walk, I wasn't expecting it to be raining. But I suppose that adds a little extra something to the walk. Although I could do without the soggy socks. So here we are at King and Yonge, so I'll be taking a left here. And let's see if I can avoid getting splashed on. I suppose I can do other walks like this with different variations. Left, right, or mix it up a bit, go right, left, or left, right. Or I could do things like flip a coin to decide whether I go right or left. Of course, both my hands are full right now, so flipping a coin isn't really an option. Some abandoned shoes. I wonder if these ones are more waterproof than the shoes I'm wearing right now. They probably are. Alright, so here's the next major intersection, so I'll be taking a right again. Adelaide Street. Time to take another left. Victoria Street. I suppose this street counts. Well, it's kind of had my eyes on Queen, but this is actually the next street, so I'm going to be taking a right here. Have to keep an eye out for these sort of side streets. So used to walking on the major streets most of the time. This is Lombard Street. Here's another new tower that is just getting underway, right across the street from another one that's a little further along. Church Street will be transformed in the next few years, becoming a high-rise canyon. Alright, now time to take another left. See, it's kind of fun just letting the rules of the walk guide me. I just have to remember when I'm supposed to go right and when I'm supposed to go left. And here I'm right again. Richmond Street East. And while side streets definitely count, I'm not going to include laneways or alleyways. I might save that for a different video. Time for another left turn here at Jarvis Street. For another right turn here at Queen Street. I suppose I can cross on the other side. maybe I can't actually. There's construction there. I'll go back to this side. Because in Toronto, no sidewalk goes unobstructed. Looks like the next left turn will be at Sherbourne Street. So George Street would be going through here, but it's interrupted by Moss Park. Kind of interesting how the rules of the walk have taken me from the heart of the financial district at King and Bay to the sketchiest intersection in the city here at Queen and Sherbourne. After the left turn. So now I'm thinking this walk will take me into Regent Park. I think if I turned right at Queen instead of Lombard, though, that would have taken me into St. Jamestown. Just walking past the sketchy Dollarama. Looks like I'll be spared from walking through Dundas and Sherbourne, since I'll be taking a right here at Shooter. That's the other sketchiest intersection in the city. Not sure who's the winner. It can change from year to year. Maybe now Dundas and Sherbourne is sketchier. I think in other years, Queen and Sherbourne was sketchier. But here we are now on Shooter Street. If I'm lucky, this might take me near the Freshco grocery store at Parliament and Dundas, because I do have to stop by a grocery store and grab a few things. Now we get to walk down our first residential street. And the rain is sort of kicking it up a notch here. Take a left here at Seaton Street. Make sure there's no cyclists coming. The residential side streets in this area are actually very nice. So these 19th century row homes and semi-detached homes. Looks like this one is in need of some renovation. Its twin though is looking good. There's a laneway, as I mentioned. I won't be taking laneways on this walk. And we're at Dundas Street. And here's Ontario Street, so I'll be taking a left here. Royal Oak Inn. I wonder what the rooms are like in there. This is a very long light here. It might take up all my time. I'm almost at the 30-minute mark already. Might have to basically wrap it up here at Dundas in Ontario. Wow. What is the deal with this light? This might be one where I have to push the button to get it to acknowledge my presence. Like pedestrians don't exist if you don't push the button. But yeah, we're just about at 30 minutes, so I guess we know where I will end up after 30 minutes of taking right turns and left turns at every intersection, starting from King and Bay. And we ended up here at Dundas and Ontario Street. Just a few blocks west of Regent Park, which is just up in that direction, where those tall buildings are. And the light finally changed. So I'm going to wrap up the video. I hope you enjoyed this kind of adventurous walk where I didn't know where I would end up. So leave a comment below. Let me know if you enjoyed this and if you'd like to see me do more walks like this, where I let the rules of the walk guide me. I mentioned some different ways to do it earlier in the video. I think I might try some of those for future walks. So yeah. Also, be sure to like, share, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And be sure to hit that notification bell, that way you won't miss any of my videos. And if you'd like to support the channel, there are links in the description where you can do so via PayPal, as well as via my merch store. And as in addition, there's a super thanks button right down below. If you'd like to support the channel that way. And you can also find me on Instagram under K Continuum. So thanks for watching, and be sure to keep checking back, because as always, I will continue.